Hey Bill, this is John Kerry. I'm going to take my distributor apart to show you kind of how this one is put together and what the screw looks like. So first I'll pull off the rotor cap, which I think just pulls straight up. And then inside there, I don't know if you can see with the light, I'm just sort of standing near the doorway in my garage, but there's a small flathead, looks like round head screw that's down inside there. So let me take that out. Not real tight because I had this all apart and cleaned everything and then put it back the way I found it. Oops, it's still got a little thread on it, I guess. I should have mentioned that when I'll put this back together and I'll show you in a minute, but when I took it apart, it really doesn't have. So here you can see what that is. That's not a fan. It doesn't look like a fancy screw to me. In fact, I'll check the thread, but I think it's a number 10, 1032 thread, and it's just a round head screw with a slot that fits down in that little hole. Now, when the shaft is put in and this screw is tightened down, there was no washer in there that I can see. The top of this shaft is not exactly machined flat either. It's kind of got a little taper on it, and there's a little step inside here that stops the screw from going all the way down. So once this is in place and you drop the screw in there, the screw tightens up on the upper shaft against that little shoulder that's down inside there. Let me tighten this up. Just doing it off camera, sorry. I'll just do it now. I'm not going to crank it super tight. I don't think you can really or shouldn't really pull it up super tight. But it's threading into the lower shaft, and then the upper shaft is captured by the shoulder. Okay. Now, lifting up and down, there is just that much movement. And I mean, it's barely noticeable, but I don't think I can get enough light on this for you to really see what I'm seeing, but it's a couple of thou maybe at the most. So there's a little looseness, but not much. So there you go. That's what this looks like. And this is a part number, where is it? 40887D, and then down below that says 363. So this was what was original on my 3.8. And oh, here we go. It's a 22D on the top here. So it had the vacuum advance and retard thumb screw here. Okay, I hope that helps. Bye.